Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_010_BIAB_I where you saved it. You can also download this file on the website. In today's tutorial, we're going to model the slab for this project. Go to the ground floor plan in the project browser. Zoom out to see the entire model. Go to the architectural tab, building panel, and select the floor slab command. In the properties palette, click the edit type button. Click the duplicate. Rename this floor to ground floor 6 inches and click OK. Click the edit structure and change the thickness to 6 inches. Click OK. Click OK to close the dialog box. In the drop panel, select the pick line button. Click at the edge of this wall. Click this reference plane, this wall, face this wall. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Trim and extend this. Click on join if Revit give a warning to adjoin. Go to the modify panel and click the split element tool. Zoom in into this area and click to split this sketch line. Click to split this sketch line. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Select the sketch line, this line, this sketch line, this sketch line. Select this sketch line, this sketch line. Click the green check mark to end the command. Click yes, click OK. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Now select the slab. Go to the clipboard panel and select copy. Click the edit boundary. Go to the modify panel and select the align command. Hover the mouse cursor into the face of this wall and click this sketch line to align it. Hover the mouse cursor to the face of this wall and click this sketch line to align it. Go to the ground floor plan. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line and this sketch line. This sketch line and this sketch line. Click on join. Select this sketch line, 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 this sketch line. Go to the modify panel and select the align command. Zoom in into this area. Select and align this wall. Select and align this wall. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Hover your mouse cursor to the sketch line and press the tab key. Click, hit delete on your keyboard. Hover the mouse cursor, press the tab key, click and hit delete on your keyboard. Hover your mouse cursor, press the tab key, click and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the mode panel and click the green check mark to complete the floor. click on join. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Now go to the modify panel, click the down arrow and select align to the same place. Click the edit boundary. Go to the ground floor plan. Click the trim extend to corner. Select this line and this line. This line, this line. Go to the modify panel and select the align command. Zoom in into this area. Select the edge of this wall and click to align this sketch line. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line and this sketch line. Press escape. Hover the mouse cursor and press the tab key. Click and hit delete on your keyboard. Hover the mouse, select this sketch line, hold the control key and select the second sketch line. Click delete to delete the subject. Click the green check mark to end the command. Select no for the moment. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Now select this floor. Go to the clipboard panel and select the copy command. Select edit boundary. Use a window selection to sketch this, to select this sketch line. Click delete to delete. Click the green check mark. Select the charge. Hold down the shift key and a middle mouse button to orbit. Now select the slab. Hit select edit boundary and click OK. Select no. Now select the offset from level minus 0 space 6. Move the mouse cursor to see the result. Still the floor move along with this. We're going to adjust this in a minute. To solve this problem, now let's delete this floor and draw it separately to avoid this problem. Go to the ground floor plan. Architectural tab, building panel, and select the floor plan command. Select the rectangle. Click from this corner, zoom in and snap to this corner. The height offset from level change 6 minus, change it to minus 0 space 6. Move the mouse cursor to the property palette. Click the green check mark. Select no. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Even though the wall is above the slab, we'll take care of this problem in a minute. Click the X button to close this view. Go to the architectural tab, building panel, and select the floor plan. In the draw panel, select the rectangle. Start the floor from this corner and snap to this intersection. Change the height offset from level to minus 1 foot. Move the mouse cursor away from the property palette. Click the green check mark. Answer no to this dialog box. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Again, the slab is below the wall. We'll take care of this problem in a minute. We need to move this wall aligned to this slab. To do that, go to the modify panel and select the align command. Zoom in close and select the face of this slab. Then click the face of this wall. wall move into position together with its article. Press escape to get out of the command. Now change the visual style, the view detail to fine, and the visual style to shade. Go to the foundation plan, click the down arrow next to select, and uncheck underlay elements so that you cannot select all the underlay elements in this view. Now go to the 3D view, select this wall, hold down the control key and pick this wall, attach top base and select this floor. Click to end the command. Select this wall, hold down the control and select this wall. Go to the modify wall panel and select the attach top base. Select this floor. Click outside to deselect. Select this wall, attach top base, and select this floor. Click outside to get out of the command. Now go to the foundation plan view, click the trim extend to corner, select this face and extend this wall, select this face, 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 extend this wall. Select this face, extend this wall. Select the face, extend this wall. Go to the 3D view to see the results. Alright, we're going to end this tutorial. We're going to stop this tutorial at this point. In the next tutorial, we'll continue to model our floor. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to a friend. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class.